thousand-year-old sorceress. Each arthritic joint a crumbling amphitheater where stories of love and madness, stupidity, delight, and unspeakable cruelty had been played out for centuries. That's how Arundhati Roy has described Delhi in her book, The Ministry of Utmost Happiness. Delhi chai ki yaad aa gayi. Purani Delhi ki galiyan first explored through the eyes of Aftab, a little kid who lived somewhere right here actually. While his sisters and brother went to school, Aftab spent hours on the tiny balcony of his home looking down at Chitli Kabar, the tiny shrine of the spotted goat who was said to have had supernatural powers, and the busy street that ran past it and joined the Matia Mahal Chowk. Aftab saw a tall, slim-hipped woman and then followed her down the streets. No, he wasn't a young stalker or anything. He wanted to be her. Like her, he wanted to shimmer past the meat shops where skinned carcasses of whole goats hung down like great walls of meat. He wanted to simper past the new lifestyle men's hairdressing salon, where Ilyas the barber cut Liaquat the lean young butcher's hair and shined it up with broom cream. He wanted to lift his salwar just a little as he stepped over a puddle, just enough to show off his silver anklets. He followed her down the street all the way to Turkman Gate and stood for a long time outside the blue doorway she disappeared into. Aftab learned later the Haveli was called the Khwabka, the House of Dreams.
So there are blue doors and there are old doors and there are beautiful doors and there are worn out doors. But lagta hai Khwabka is just the House of Dreams.
Aftab becomes Anjum and she goes to live in a Kabristan. So we set out to find that Kabristan. And this is where we landed up. We're at a Kabristan behind G.B. Pant Hospital near Delhi Gate. It's called Mehendiyan.
It was an unpossessing graveyard, run down, not very big and used only occasionally. Its northern boundary abutted a government hospital and mortuary where the bodies of the city's vagrants and unclaimed dead were warehoused until the police decided how to dispose of them.
So Purani Delhi is completely different from Nayi Delhi. It has its own aura. From the galiyan to Jama Masjid to Red Fort, there's just so much to get lost in.
The fort loomed over the old city, a massive sandstone plateau, so vast a part of the skyline that local people had ceased to notice it. Grey flyovers snaked out of a Medusa skull, tangling and untangling under the yellow sodium haze. Old secrets were folded into the furrows of her loose parchment skin. Each wrinkle was a street, each street a carnival.